I love yellow, it's my favourite colour, and I love bees. And bees are one of those things that I've been able to capture and draw and make them come alive. They're always buzzing and hiding and connecting the stories between the flora and the fauna and the birds. So they call me the Bee Lady because there's not one artwork that doesn't have a bee. Isolation in the valley is absolutely bliss for an artist. You start here, close your eyes and listen. So I went for walks through the valley. My senses were reawakened from all teaching I do, and I think my work has exploded in a positive way. So I was born in New Guinea, growing up there, and everything is alive. All the colours are vivid. I was lucky enough to swim across reefs with the coral coming alive. And I think it's that vividness of the landscape that has stayed with me. And I needed to bring that out at some point. It's taken nearly 60 years to get here, but I had to learn to draw the Australian bush in a way no one else has done. I had to take the conversation that I hear in the bush, the tweets, the insects, the calling, the all of that, and bring it alive, just like you can hear out there, and bring it alive onto a board so the outside is inside. If you want to really be successful in the art world, you can't just keep your work to yourself. You must exhibit. I'm a drawer, that's what I do, but to draw, mount and frame and exhibit is really expensive with glass. So I had to find a surface that allowed me to do my technique. And this wood allows me to do that, but it also allows me to leave the background plain. One of the reasons why I work in big, so I'm doing panel by panel, but there's no plan whether it becomes a 2, a 6, a 9, a 12, is that I can exaggerate the size of the flora, the insects and the birds and the fauna, and create a sense of perspective. So the viewer can view it flat, just looking at it, or they can immerse themselves and walk through it and listen and look and smell and lose themselves, because we don't actually take time to stop. I've been lucky to be given 3 commissions, but those things have come out of, I feel, people who haven't been able to go anywhere and so spend their time surfing the internet for inspiration. So for artists, I think it's been amazing. A lot of online stuff came through, and the interaction between artists from all over the world has been unbelievable. To do a virtual gallery tour is exciting. Exhibiting is putting your work and your soul out there to be totally deconstructed. I was lucky to be a finalist in the Gallipoli Art Prize this year, and it was a sheer joy to be chosen and then hung with a number of other fabulous artists. So my brother used to come home from the caves in New Guinea with either live or not live grenades. So I knew the weight, I knew I'd felt them, the bullets, guns, everything came through. I need to draw the mechanisms. So I thought if I dissected the poppy and I could look at an image of a dissected grenade, would the mechanisms be similar? And yes, they are similar. except one gives back to the earth and one takes away. I have entered a number of major competitions and now it's a waiting game. On the day they're going to release the finalists, and often it's 5 o'clock at night or 7 o'clock at night. So you've got to spend the whole day really, really busy. Really busy. And don't think. And don't show disappointment. Because it's someone else who judged it and they didn't see what you thought was valuable at that point. It's not a negative, it's just a journey.
I thought I'd share with you where I work Thursdays and Fridays at the John Collett School. The children are the essential workers. We're still having class, so I would go in and teach one or two days a week, Thursday and Friday. And I teach years 4, 5, and 6, about an hour and a half a week, looking at various artists, at techniques, and opening their eyes that art reflects what is happening in the world.
The lockdown went on and on and on. The parents didn't want their art lessons to stop, but also my private students, they wanted to learn to be taught on Zoom. And that was so different because it was when you're teaching through a lens, it's even harder. And so I don't know how I did it, actually, or do it. I don't want to do it often. I can't read their minds, but when you're in there, you can see the hesitation with the holding of the pencil, or they're looking at you. So there's this interaction that is unsaid, is unspoken, and that's what I miss.
It's been a most amazing experience, being isolated and not coming and teaching. It's given me time to reflect how much I do love teaching and that I love that contact, looking at the children, looking at any of my students as they create and being able to correct them on the spot and see that moment of realization and absolute joy at getting something done.